Hey guys, how's it going? BCHD here and welcome back to another video on the channel. Today, it's a bit different. As we know, the 2018 Russia World Cup is literally just around the corner. A few days from now, literally 2 days away, and we are right around the corner from the biggest event in the world. Kicking off, depending on where you are, Thursday night or Friday morning. For us Australians, it is Friday morning, 1 a.m. The biggest tournament in the world is kicking off. All eyes will be on Russia and the 32 nations competing in this year's competition. And as you can see here, I'm gonna put my footballing knowledge and predicting skills to the test with this 2018 prediction of the FIFA World Cup in Russia. Let's predict the groups, let's predict the knockouts using this predictor, and let's see who I come up with to eventually win the whole tournament and become champions of the world for 2018. If you guys do end up enjoying this video, smack the like button for more football related videos like this if you're keen on seeing them. Subscribe if you're new around here and want to see more World Cup content on the channel. Follow me on Twitter, the link is in the description at BCHDOfficial. And let's get straight into the predicting of the 2018 Russia World Cup. Alright, here in front of us we have all the groups A through to H. Let's get it started with who is going to make it out of Group A. Okay, so one of the reasons why I've left this World Cup prediction to literally 2 days before the tournament is because generally I'm a last minute person, and second of all, you don't know what squads, like the squads need to be announced, you don't know what players are injured, you don't know what's going to happen with the teams. So usually, say if I did this a couple of weeks ago, maybe before the Champions League final, I would have maybe predicted Egypt to get out of this Group A, but because probably their best player, Mohamed Salah, is one, injured from the Champions League final, and two, is going to come back not full fitness, I'm really not looking, I'm not predicting Egypt to make it out of this one alive. I mean, Uruguay will definitely come first in this one, and it's either between Russia or Egypt. I know Russia aren't really the best team overall, but they do have the home ground advantage, which is a really big it's a really big confidence boost advantage. The crowd is behind them wherever they go, so I just feel like Russia is going to have that extra boost, that extra fight in them to, you know, prove the world and prove Russia why they are worthy hosts of such a competition. And I feel like maybe if Mohamed Salah didn't get injured in the Champions League final and he was fresh and ready for the World Cup, I feel like Egypt could have made it. But I don't know, Russia with this home ground advantage, just because they are in the home nation, it's their World Cup, I feel like they will come second and Egypt will just narrowly miss out, very narrowly, to Russia making it out of there. Uruguay finishing top, Russia is going to make it out in sec. Now moving on to Group B, we have Spain, Morocco, Portugal and Iran, and this one is quite clear cut, but I think it might be closer than many people think. So I'm obviously going to go with Spain starting off here in first. I feel like they're just the dominant force in this group. Meanwhile, Portugal are close behind them. They are Euro 2016 champions. Ronaldo is looking to prove himself at the World Cup. Hasn't really done that as of yet. And we have Morocco, haven't been this for a while, as well as Iran, who did show up a decent fight in 2014, narrowly losing to eventual finalist Argentina in that 1-0 90th minute Messi goal. But yeah, Iran are very decent. They did really well in qualifying. Morocco also have a really balanced, really nice team. Got Ziyech, got Benatia from Juventus, but I feel like Portugal will edge this one out. I mean, it's not going to be as clear-cut, I think, as people see it, but in the end, I think Portugal will get second place here, and I feel like Morocco will be just behind them. So yeah, Group B, I know I'm going with the predictable picks, but I'm just trying to reason behind them and show you my thinking towards why I'm putting these teams where they are. Now, it's Group C. The only team I'm supporting in this World Cup due to my home nation, Italy, not qualifying. This will be a very weird feeling for a lot of Italians like myself, but Australia is my nation of birth, so I'll be going for the Socceroos in Russia. And this one, I don't know whether to go for the heart or the mind here. My mind's telling me one thing, my heart's telling me another. I'm pretty sure France will ease out of this one in first place. It's all about that second place. Peru have been showing really good form. I mean, Paulo Guerrero, their top goal scorer, is clear for the tournament. Did get that cocaine ban, but has been lifted for the World Cup as three captains of France, Australia, and Denmark have cleared him to play. We do have Denmark with Christian Eriksen. I mean, if Christian Eriksen doesn't get injured in any of these games or leading up towards the tournament, I feel like Denmark are a really, really strong contender in this group. But Peru are showing really good form and really good signs in their international friendlies leading up to the World Cup as well. We have Australia, my home nation. I mean, I got some personal bias here, and I've also got, they did win 4-0 against Czech Republic and 2-1 against Hungary in their games leading up to this tournament. And I feel like they're in a good space right now. They got some good form going into this tournament. The young Daniel Arzani, the youngest player at this World Cup right now, coming off the bench. So I feel like coming up against France, Australia have a really decent chance. I mean, France literally were losing to the USA and scraped a 1-1 draw out of that game. That was an international friendly. USA haven't even qualified for this tournament. So I don't know where they go for my heart here, but I sort of want to go for my heart with this Australia pick. It's going to be tough. I'm going to go with my heart in this one. I know it might not happen. It's probably not my real prediction, but just for this video, I want to go with my heart and say Australia finish in second whilst Denmark comes in third and Peru finish fourth. I know, guys, it's a biased pick, but for the purposes of this video, I want to see how Australia go in this prediction. As we move on to Group D, the closest thing we'll get to a group of death. In this one, we have Iceland, qualified for this first World Cup. Argentina, 2014, runners-up. Croatia, always a decent team in World Cup and Euros. And we have Nigeria with that awesome, beautiful, scintillating home kit that everyone's hyped about. And I feel like, you know, Argentina and Messi are going to ease past this group. I feel like Argentina obviously have the strongest squad. Defense maybe not, but attack will make up for it in this group. And I feel like it's been between Croatia and Nigeria in this one. Iceland, obviously, I feel like this is probably going to be one of the tightest groups in the whole tournament. I mean, Croatia have got that midfield. Just Modric, Kovacic, Rakitic, Brozovic, Mandzukic, Perisic, I mean, Subasic, they got so many good players, decent players that play at a high European level. Meanwhile, Iceland have a few Premier League players here and there. Nigeria also do as well. This one's probably the toughest one. It's going to go down to the wire. I feel like it's going to go down to the last match day in this one, but I feel like I'm edging towards Croatia, and then Nigeria just finishes third because of that saucy home kit. But we're moving to the last four groups of the tournament. Group E, Serbia, Brazil, Switzerland, and Costa Rica. And I'm just going to go flat out and say Brazil is winning this one. They have had some good form leading up to the World Cup. Neymar obviously coming back from injury, and they are looking to, you know, redeem themselves after the 2014 7-1 against Germany in the semi-finals. Yeah, I feel like they have the strongest team in this group. Great goalkeeping choices in Edison, played for Man City this season, had a really good season, as well as Alisson, pretty much one of Serie A's best goalkeepers, looking for a move out before the World Cup, but we'll see what happens there. So I feel like Brazil will win this one. Gabriel Jesus, Neymar, Coutinho, too strong for Serbia, Switzerland, and Costa Rica. I feel like will be one of the dark horses that people don't see coming. I feel like Serbia will finish this one in second, just because their team has come together such good form. I mean, you got Mitrovic up top, recently gained promotion for Fulham. You got Milinkovic-Savic having an exceptional season for Lazio and is looking for a move away. I feel like Switzerland will come in third, and Costa Rica, I feel like they lost 2-0 to England and they lost 4-1 to Belgium the other day. So I feel like Costa Rica aren't going to replicate the success of the 2014 World Cup, and Switzerland will come in third. Group F, we move on to as Germany, South Korea, Sweden, and Mexico in this one. And I feel like this is a simple group. Second and third will be pushed to the last day. I feel like Germany will easily sweep this group. Mexico in red hot form with Irving Lozano, Chicharito, so many good players. The passion of the Mexicans at the World Cup is always good to see. And I feel like Korea will just edge in third there, just miss out on that second spot. And Sweden, I feel like without Zlatan Ibrahimovic, without a lot of decent players, they aren't that great of a team, even though they did knock out my home nation of Italy. Group G, we move on. Probably the easiest group to predict. Belgium in there. Not really dark horses anymore. Probably one of the favorites to win or go the furthest in this World Cup. We have England in some decent form right before the World Cup. Gonna get in second there with all the young players of this side. I feel like they're going to make it out and not replicate 2014. And we have Tunisia and Panama. I just feel like Tunisia slightly stronger than Panama. And yeah, that's how that group will turn out. Probably the most predictable group of them all. We move on to Group H. One of the most balanced groups, I feel. Maybe in contention with Group D. We do have Senegal, Poland, Colombia, and Japan. I feel like Japan is the weakest out of these teams. But they always seem to perform or do something great in the group stages. In the recent World Cup, Senegal have some really decent players. They have Mane, of course, of Liverpool, Keita Balde, Koulibaly, Kouyaté from West Ham. I feel like they could surprise a few people in this group. I feel like Lewandowski or Milik up top could prove to be the difference in this group. But Colombia did have that really good 2014 World Cup run. I feel like Colombia just edged it there because of the experience. A lot of the players are from that 2014 World Cup run, so I feel like they will just nick this one in first place. For me, second and third is between Senegal and Poland. I feel like I want to say Senegal comes out on top in this one. Not on top, in second place to reach the knockouts. And I feel like Poland might disappoint a few people, and Senegal would be the surprise package of this group, with Poland and Japan finishing in third and fourth. And ladies and gentlemen, that is the predicted group stage. Let's move on to the knockout stages. All right, the round of 16. We've made it to this one. Uruguay taking on Portugal in this one. A very, very fiery affair. We have Luis Suarez and Edison Cavani taking on Cristiano Ronaldo's Portugal. And I feel like Portugal might edge this one an extra time, similar to what they did in the Euros a lot. Uruguay, obviously a decent team, will be coming in to this round of 16 in red-hot form after topping Group A, I feel. I just feel like Portugal might edge this one, and I feel like they will win it in extra time or penalties. Sorry, Uruguay fans. I feel like this is probably one of the best games of the round of 16 here. We do have France and Croatia next. France, obviously one of the favorites to win. They've got probably one of the best squads in this tournament. Mbappe, Dembele, all those great young, youthful players. The speed, the flair they have in their team. Croatia, I feel, won't go down easy in this one, but I feel like France might edge it 2-1 or 1-0 in this one. Not a high-scoring affair. I feel like Croatia will hang on, but France in the end will turn out on top in that one. So Portugal-France quarterfinal. Move on to Brazil taking on Mexico in the round of 16. And of course, we know about Mexico's round of 16 curse, never getting past the round of 16, never playing that elusive fifth game that all Mexicans dream of. And I don't feel like the curse will be broken in Russia, as Brazil obviously are going to be too strong for the Mexicans, even though they will put up a really, really decent fight, I feel. But the Brazilians will take out the Mexicans. I feel like Brazil, with the stronger team, Mexico will put up a fight, but Brazil just that tad stronger, as we come up with Belgium taking on Senegal. The surprise packages of Group H, I felt that Belgium will edge them out in that one, and I feel like Senegal will do themselves proud and finish in the round of 16. We have Spain taking on the hosts in this one. It's weird because in the FIFA 18 World Cup game mode, Russia, usually in most of my simulations, have knocked out Spain in this case, but I feel like in real life, Spain will just be too much for the Russians, even though I feel like the home crowd advantage will do them well. I feel like Spain's team will edge them out in experience and, you know, just generally overall, the terms of quality Spain have. But yeah, I feel like Spain will edge that one out and come up on top. And we have the one here, Argentina taking on Australia. And I know I did that biased pick in that Group C, but I mean, I can't be biased here. I've got to be realistic. I've got to think with my head in this one. If it was with my heart, I'd say Australia to win the World Cup. But obviously, that is not going to happen in terms of predictions or happening anytime soon. Lionel Messi will score a hat-trick against Australia, and Argentina will go through to the quarterfinals of the World Cup as we move on to Germany. My favorite kit in this World Cup. I actually have the home jersey in real life. I'm planning to get the away jersey as well. Such quality, decent kits. I love them so much. My dark horse is Serbia, and this one will be knocked out. And I feel like Germany will take this one and advance to the quarterfinals of the World Cup. Serbia, the dark horses, for me, will be knocked out. And we have Colombia. James Rodriguez, Colombia, that made it all the way to the quarters in 2014, face England, the young, hungry squad, Harry Kane as their captain. I mean, probably one of the youngest squad England has seen at a World Cup in a few years, and at a major tournament as well. And I really, really want England to do well this year. I mean, pretty much all the tournaments I've seen England in, they've been knocked out in the group stage, knocked out really early in the tournament. So I feel like I want them to do well, but I know Colombia will be a tough, tough challenge for them. They have performed well in their friendlies against big opposition, but Colombia and James Rodriguez, as much as I love Colombia, their style of play, their kits, I feel like they're going to be edged out by England in extra time. As we have the quarterfinal set up, we're going to move back to Portugal taking on France, a replay of the Euro 2016 final. I'd love to see this happen in the actual World Cup. It will be a very, very fiery affair. I feel like France will need to get some revenge on Portugal winning the Euros in extra time on their home soil. And France will be in hot form going into this one, and Portugal, I don't think will last against the French, and they'll just be too strong for them in the end. France going through to the semis as we move on to Brazil versus Belgium. Probably, I mean, all these quarterfinal matchups are just absolutely amazing, but Brazil taking on Belgium will be one of the highlights of the tournament. Brazil, Neymar, Jesus, Coutinho. I've said it before, France want to redo the wrongs of Euro 2016, and Brazil want to redo the wrongs of 2014 World Cup in Brazil. So for me, Brazil take out that one. As we move on to Spain, Argentina, Messi versus pretty much all his teammates in Barcelona. Busquets, Iniesta, you've got all the Spanish defenders, Pique, Ramos, Alba. We've got David De Gea in goal for Spain here. Argentina, their defense is a bit shaky in this one, but can Messi carry them? I don't think so, as Spain recently in a friendly beat Argentina 6-1, was it 6 or 5-1? Something ridiculous like that. Spain absolutely taught them a lesson in that game. Absolutely, men versus boys. Will that repeat in this quarterfinal? I don't think so, but Spain, I mean, David De Gea in goal, Argentina's defense isn't that strong, and for me, Spain in that one will take it out, as we have the big one. Germany taking on England, old enemies in this World Cup quarterfinal, as Germany did beat them in 2010 with that Lampard ghost goal. England want to get revenge on Germany, but Germany, I mean, you can't go past that squad. England don't really have that much of a great record against Germany. I mean, they did win the World Cup in 1966 against West Germany, but not this Germany here. And England, I mean, a lot of England fans would take a quarterfinal. So, and for England to get to the quarters would be a big achievement. And Germany probably want to get in the final this year to back up their 2014 win. So Germany, for me, edges that one out against England. And we have some saucy semi-final as we have France taking on Brazil, Spain against Germany. This will be a big, big, big one, as these are pretty much all big teams. I can back up any winner in this case scenario. France versus Brazil will be attack, attack, attack. Spain versus Germany will just be a tactical masterclass, tactical overload from both managers. As Spain with that tiki-taka, Germany with that German football that we all know so well after they won that World Cup and went far in the Euros 2 years ago. Spain with the tiki-taka. I just can't in this one. Germany, of course, I love their kits this year. I love their team. I feel like it might be even stronger than 2014. But Spain also do have a really, really nice team this year. But are they as hungry as they once were in 2008 and 2010 when they won the Euro and World Cup? I'm not sure in this one. But France versus Brazil, obviously, all these four teams are favourites to take it out. So I feel like one of these four teams will make it this far, of course, or make it into the final. They'll be in and around this stage unless there's a shock elimination. But I've got to go with Brazil or France. Man, this is too hard. I'm going to be sitting here for days arguing why these teams are going to make it into the final. But of course, only one team will make it. Ah, oh, this is hard. I know I'm gonna get a lot of hate. I'm gonna get a lot of dislikes, but I gotta go with my gut feeling. I mean, I predicted Germany to win the World Cup in 2014. I gotta go with them here in 2018. And France and Brazil. Now at this point, Brazil, their team is better than 2014, and they made the semi-finals in 2014. I know it was on home turf, but they were playing exceptionally well with that team, with Fred up top. I mean, they've pretty much upgraded every single position in this new World Cup with this new squad. I feel like Brazil will edge out France. I know there's a lot of pressure on France to go far. They are pretty much the favorite to win this one alongside Germany. And I feel like the pressure will get to Deschamps and the whole team. The nightmare of Euros 2016 will get in their way. So Brazil versus Germany in the final. This will be a game to go down in the history books, I feel. Brazil, Germany, two historic nations in the world of football. Germany, if they win this one, will have more World Cups than Italy. Of course, they're both tied on four. And Brazil are the World Cup, in terms of winning the World Cup, they're the number one nation to have World Cups. This is hard, man, but I feel Brazil or Germany, man. It's what happens on the day, what happens, anyone can win this, especially with the semis and quarters, man. Whoever turns up on the day will win, but I feel like Brazil versus Germany. Oh, I completely forgot. This is a rematch of the semi-final in 2014. I'm so dumb. Anyway, this 2014 rematch, Brazil taking on Germany, 7-1 in 2014. We all know what happened. We all watched it. I couldn't believe it. And I feel like Germany couldn't believe it as well. But Brazil want revenge. I know this will be a really big grudge match for them, considering Germany knocked them out of their own tournament in their own nation. And I feel Brazil, Neymar, Coutinho, Gabriel Jesus, that midfield, Casemiro. Brazil are my World Cup champions, man. This is too much. I could have gone with Germany. I love Germany as well in terms of their players, their kits, their team, their overall philosophy of football. I just love. But in terms of this case scenario, the storyline behind this game, Brazil might edge it out for me in penalties, even though the Germans are known to be one of the best penalty takers in the world. Yeah, Brazil, just that attack is lethal, and I feel like they'll get their revenge in 2018, 4 years on from that 7-1 defeat, becoming world champions for the first time since 2002. Brazil are World Cup champions 16 years later. They've made it 16 years later. They've got their hands on another World Cup. This is my prediction for the 2018 World Cup. I am so pumped for this World Cup. If you guys are, smash the like button. Comment down below. What do you think I got wrong? What are you going to blast me for in the comments? I'm not sure. Maybe Australia making it out of the group. Some of you might get a bit angry at that. But if you enjoyed this video, smack a like on it. Subscribe if you're new around here and want some more World Cup content. I'll be bringing some out across the whole tournament, the whole month, full of World Cup action, World Cup content on the channel. Follow me on Twitter. The link is in the description. Hope you guys enjoy the World Cup, and I'll catch you guys in the very next video.